So currently we're standing on the Wairoa River staging bridge. And so this bridge is used effectively to build the river bridge into the river. So we have to build a bridge effectively to build the bridge. And it's also going to be used as a main haul road for the heavy vehicles and equipment to be used for earthworks.
The Takitimu North Link is part of the New Zealand Upgrade Program, which was an $8.7 billion program that the government announced. It's one of the projects that Waka Kotahi is delivering. It's 6.8 kilometres of expressway that is in construction.
Yeah, the design for the Wairoa River Bridge is really interesting. It needs to span the river, obviously, but also span across the floodplain so that once a bridge is constructed, it doesn't result in upstream flooding or other impacts.
Before we go in and touch any of our streams or waterways, we have to do defishing. And what defishing means is if we're building a new channel for the stream, we have to go in and do trapping and mucking out, and we have to move any of those fish out of those waterways to enable us to put the new waterway in place without harming them. So down in the valley behind me, we relocated thousands of fish. Once we've done all of our fauna relocation, we then come in and set the site up for earthworks.
Building over a river and over a watercourse comes with lots of considerations, particularly in terms of health and safety and in terms of local stakeholders as well. We're working at heights, which comes with its own safety requirements. We're doing like hot works, and we also have to comply with the maritime transport operating procedure.
Building near the awa and near any waterways is probably the pinnacle of risk when it comes to erosion and sediment control for any earthwork site. You're careful no matter where you are and no matter what you do, but when you've got a waterway, we look at that and go, anything can get in there and it's gone in an instant. So your impact that you can have is quite great.
Takitimu North Link is about a 5-year project. And over that time, it gives us a great opportunity to invest in broader outcomes. So it provides opportunity for education for all the parties involved, so we can learn what actually happened in this region. We've got kaitiaki on site. There's a lot of archaeology that we're exploring as well.
So when the kaitiaki turns up in the morning, he will or she will mihi to the awa and the taniwha and wish everyone a good day and prosperous day. I come down every day and watch it a little bit more, a little bit more, a little bit more. You know, and then just when it finally got to this side and it touched this side, it felt like this is a real project. Hey, it's gonna happen. Part A of this bridge is finished. Now let's start part B.